start our first chapter, that is the introduction to chemistry. Okay, so if you will take the term chemistry, what do you mean by chemistry? Suppose if I will ask you, what comes to your mind when you are thinking about chemistry? You might be thinking of some lab, one laboratory. You might be thinking of some chemicals. You might be thinking about some person wearing white color aprons. Okay, so these all things came to our mind when we are thinking about chemistry. But chemistry is not only these things, rather we can say everything around us is a chemistry. The air we breathe, the cloth that we are wearing, the things that we are using in our day-to-day life, everything around us, we can say that all the matter around us is chemistry, because they are made up of some types of chemical constituents. So we can say everything around us is chemistry. So here in this chapter only we will have some introductory part for chemistry. So I have also prepared a note for you. One by one I will explain, and at last also I will give the picture of this explanation. Okay, so here I have written, everything on earth is made up of matter, and matter is made up of atoms. So I think you all have some idea about atom. What do you mean by an atom? Atom is the smallest particle of a matter. What is matter? Everything around us, the desk, the bench, the fan, we ourselves, everything around us, we call it as a matter. And matter consists of very small particles. Suppose if I will take a piece of chalk and I will break it. I will again break the small piece. Again I will break the small piece. And again I will break the small piece. But a time will come, after that I cannot break the piece of chalk. That is the smallest part of the chalk piece. Just I am giving the example. Like that, every matter around us consists of some small particles. And that smallest particle of an atom is known, of a matter is known as an atom. So atoms are the smallest particle of a matter. Okay, so here also I have written the definition of atom: smallest unit of a matter which cannot be divided further. It is the smallest unit of a matter. Beyond that, again we cannot break it. Okay, that is the last smallest particle of a matter. Now we can define chemistry. Here I have given a simple definition. If you are finding difficulty from your book's definition, don't go for that. Just have a look to this definition. So we can define chemistry as, it is a branch of science which deals with the study of matter. Understood up to this? It is a branch of science which deals with the study of matter, its property, means the property of matter, and how atoms in a matter combine to form new substance. Again, I am repeating the definition. It is a branch of science which deals with the study of matter, the property of matter, and how atoms in a matter combine with each other to form a new substance. This is called chemistry. Okay, we can define chemistry like this. Now, chemistry is derived from a Greek word. Here I have written, in ancient time, at first, chemistry is derived from a Greek word, and that word is alchemy. Here I have written, you can see this. Chemistry derived from a Greek word, and that word is what? That word is alchemy. Okay? And the person who practice alchemy, means the person who are working in the laboratory in the search of new products, they are known as alchemist. Okay? So again I'm repeating, chemistry is derived from a Greek word, and that word is alchemy. Persons, those who are practicing chemistry, they are known as alchemists. Here I have written alchemists. into gold. By the use of that stone, they can convert any metal into gold. And they call it as a miracle, but they don't know this is chemistry. Okay? And these philosopher stones are also used to cure several diseases. In ancient time, they are also using this philosopher stone to cure several diseases. Okay? So chemistry is a very older term, but people at that time they are not knowing about the term chemistry, rather they are using it in their day-to-day life. Slowly they are well acquainted with the term, okay, and now we are calling it as chemistry. Okay, so here I have written one question. A substance that can change any metal to gold. What? Philosopher's stone. Again one question I have written. Philosopher's stone is a substance used to cure disease in ancient times. This question may come. Dex is a substance used to cure diseases in ancient time. What do you mean by philosopher's stone? Already we have discussed. Now, gradually they tried to name the elements. Suppose hydrogen. Rather calling it hydrogen, they just named it as H. We can represent hydrogen as H. Oxygen, we can represent oxygen as O or O2. Nitrogen, we can represent nitrogen as N. So, like this, they gave different small names. As we have given pet names in our house, like that, they gave small names to the elements. Okay? And that is known as symbol. Okay? Gradually, they discovered symbol, and some kind of stone, we call it as philosopher's stone, which they are using to cure several diseases. And also, this stone is used to convert metal into gold. Okay, now another question. Dex gave the first basic chemical hypothesis. Aristotle. The answer is Aristotle. Aristotle is a scientist who gave the first basic chemical hypothesis. Next, Dex is known as father of early chemistry. Means in early time, who gave some terms of chemistry? Geber. G-E-B-E-R. Geber. Geber is known as the father of early chemistry. Dex is the father of modern chemistry. Robert Boyle. Okay? These three questions also I have given. Dex gave the first chemical hypothesis. Aristotle. Dex is known as the father of ancient chemistry or early chemistry. We can call it, answer it as Geber. Dex is the father of modern chemistry, Robert Boyle. Okay, these all are some short questions. Okay, you read your book, but don't get confused after reading all the sentences of your book. Just go through the short things that I have given. Okay, then again read out your book. Now we will go to our next part. Notable chemist. Okay, notable chemist. Okay, before going to this, one more topic it is given. In your book, it is given about Qutub Minar. Okay, see if you have ever been to Qutub Minar, then you can see a long, iron rod. It is very long. The height is, I cannot tell the exact height. We can find it. It is very long and it is also very strong. And it was made so many years before. But till now, it is as it is shining. Why? Because at that time, they used pure form of iron to build the long iron rod in front of Qutub Minar. So we can say that chemistry they are using before a long back, but they are not knowing the use of chemistry. Later on, gradually they know the use of chemistry. Okay, so next topic we will start about notable chemistry, chemists. Okay, call them as chemists. Some notable chemists means some chemists, those who have made important discoveries about them, some few of them we will read here. Okay. First, Antoni Lohister. Antoni Lohister is a chemist who developed metric system. Here I will tell you what is metric system. Metric system means in laboratories we need to weigh of certain chemicals. So that chemicals cannot be measured in normal weighing machines. For the measurement of chemicals, different devices are designed, and that kind of system to weigh different chemicals we call it as metric system. Metric systems are used to measure the weight of several chemical chemical compounds. Okay. He also formulated a law of conservation of mass. About this law you will read in your higher class, but now just remember the law of conservation of mass. And also he found chemical nomenclature. I am also telling about nomenclature. What is nomenclature? Nomenclature means naming. Just before I was saying that they name different elements like hydrogen, oxygen, nitrogen, helium, lithium. This is called naming. So he formulated different chemical names, and this is called as chemical nomenclature. Okay. So he found metric system, law of conservation of mass, and chemical nomenclature. Now come to the second chemist, John Dalton. He developed Dalton's law. For about these laws you will read in your higher class. For now just remember these terms. Okay. John Dalton developed Dalton's law. John Jacob Berzelius. I know these names are a little bit hard and confusing for you, but gradually while reading you will get acquainted with these names. Okay. John Jacob Berzelius, he developed symbols and formulas. Means what are symbols? For hydrogen we are using the symbol H. For water we are using H2O is the formula. Okay. H is the symbol of hydrogen and H2O is the water formula. Means here two hydrogen and one oxygen combine with each other to form water. Okay. So he developed symbols and formulas. About these in detail we will read in our next chapter about symbols and formulas. Fourth, Louis Pasteur. Okay, he discovered pasteurization. I think pasteurization is a familiar term for you. If not, then I'm telling. See, there is a process of boiling milk. When we are using milk, we generally boil the milk. We never take raw milk. We generally boil it, then we are taking it. Why? To kill the microorganisms inside the milk. And also, we can store that milk for longer period. This process of killing germs by heating is known as pasteurization. Pasteurization is a process of boiling several substances, and to kill the germs by boiling is known as pasteurization. So Louis Pasteur, from the name only you can say, Louis Pasteur develops pasteurization. Number 5, Dmitri Mendeleev. Dmitri Mendeleev is a scientist who developed the periodic table. What is periodic table means? Suppose I am giving you one example. In your section, we are taking or we for to take the attendance, we are naming, we are noting down your names one by one according to your alphabet, so that it will be easy for you. Roll number 1 means we can identify who is roll number 1. Like that, there are so many elements. Till now 118 elements are discovered. That elements means the hydrogen, oxygen, H2O, these all are calling elements. About this we will read in our next chapter. Okay, there are 118 elements. So how we can identify the elements? They need to be arranged properly. This arrangement of elements according to their property is known as periodic table. So Dmitri Mendeleev developed the first periodic table. Again I am saying, do not get confused. We will have these topics in our next chapter. I will tell you detail about atoms, molecule, elements and periodic table, symbol, formula, all we will discuss in our next chapter. Now just get acquainted with the words. Okay, DMAT Mendeleev, the block, the first periodic table. Next, number 6, Alfred Barnhand Nobel. He invented dynamite. Okay, dynamite is an explosive material. Generally, in the crackers that we are using during Diwali, there also little bit amount of dynamite is there. So dynamites are used for explosion. Who discovered dynamite? Alfred Nobel. And he got Nobel Prize also for his invention. 7. Niels Bohr. Niels Bohr is a scientist who developed the structure of atom. He developed about atom. He said about atom. So what is the name? Niels Bohr. He developed atom. Next, number 8. Scaldon Curie. He discovered radium. Radium is a very familiar term to you. Generally, you are using radium toys. It is very common. I saw that different stars, moon and all you are keeping on the roof of your room. And when you will switch off the light, you can see lighting coming out from that things that are made up of radium. So radium is an element which gives light in dark. Okay, that is discovered by Scaldon Curie. She is the first lady to get the Nobel Prize for this work. Okay, next, Ernst Rutherford. He discovered nucleus in atoms. As our cell contains nucleus, atoms also contains nucleus. About this in detail we will have in our next chapter. Nucleus, electron, proton, these all we will discuss later. For now just remember, he discovered nucleus in atoms. Next, Geoffrey Mostry. He discovered atomic number. Okay, about all this please don't get confused. I cannot explain you all the term at a time because you will have a confusion of these all terms. Just remember the names of these terms. We will have a clear discussion about this in our next chapter. Okay, so he discovered atomic number. Who? Geoffrey Mostry. Number 11. This is an Indian scientist, Prafulla Chandra Roy. I think this word, this name will be very easy for you to remember. Prafulla Chandra Roy set up the first chemical factory. He is from Bangalore. I think he is from Kolkata, and he set up the first chemical factory in West Bengal. Okay. Next, Hargobind Khurana. He is also an Indian scientist. He discovered that nucleic acids control the synthesis of protein. So generally, the protein inside our body gets synthesized by a thing we call as nucleic acid. Okay, nucleic. Just for now, just remember, nucleic acid is a substance inside our body which synthesizes protein in our body. Okay, who discovered this? Hargobind Khurana. The last is C.H.R. Rao. I have written in your book. It is given Chintamani. Nageshwar Ramachandra Rao. Okay, some name is there. Okay, C.H.R. Rao I have written. He worked on structural chemistry and nanotechnology. Okay, nowadays the nanotechnology is vastly used in medical science. Okay, nanotechnology is a term by using that several devices we can produce, several instruments they are producing, and they are using this nanotechnology widely nowadays in medical science. Okay, so these all are the notable chemists. Again I am saying, this is the first class of chemistry. Don't get confusion. That's why I am giving you a note, so that again and again you can go through your note, and all these terms we will discuss later on in our next chapters. Gradually you will be acquainted with these terms and you will find very easy So just go through it, prepare a note for you, learn all these things. Okay, this is the introductory part for you. Next, we will discuss some other thing about chemistry, some application of chemistry in our day-to-day.